Hey, Melissa here at Safe Haven Ministries, day 162. And we're just going to sit and take a few minutes to talk about a word that we hear, but we don't often do. And that word is meditate. Meditate. Now, some of you, when you picture meditation, or maybe it's just me, but I picture some guy on the floor humming, with his arms crossed, or he's out like this, and I think, why would I want to do that? I can look stupid enough without doing something like that. Well, the reason that we don't do it, we associate it somewhat with Eastern religions, but actually, it's a very important part of Christianity. And putting it simply, meditating really is just thinking on God and His Word, just taking time. And the word ruminate is a picture of a cow. It ruminates, it chews its cud, and it has several stomachs, and it goes into the first stomach, and it chews and chews it until it gets the good out of it, throws it back up, and puts it in the second stomach, and it starts all over the process again until it gets every nutrient out of it can. And that's the way we're supposed to handle the Word of God. Now, probably one of the word for revelation is apocalypsis. And the more you sit with the Lord and meditate, the more revelation you have on how to live your life. And the word apocalypsis or revelation, it means to pull back like a curtain, and you can see something that's been there the whole time. It just wasn't used the way it was supposed to be used. And one word like that would be like the Wright brothers. The Wright brothers wanted to fly like the birds. Well, I had looked at birds all my life, but never once did I think to myself, I'd like to fly like them, but they did. And so there was a curtain opened up, and they had revelation to that. Now, probably one of the people who chased after God more than any other was David. David just had such a heart for God. He wanted to know Him more and more. And we read in Psalms how often he listened and he talked to his father, even out in the fields. Even when he was running from Saul and dodging javelins, David made sure he took time to meditate upon the Lord. I read a story years ago about a man who was standing in a field, and a little deer was just running as fast as it could from the dogs. And they were barking and they were getting closer, and the deer was just panicked, and he came over the ridge and he saw this man. And the man said the look in that little deer's eyes was just pure terror. And she walked right up to him and put her head in his stomach and stood there and felt safe. She felt safe. You know, there's a place where you and I can run to feel safe. And that place is the arms of God. In Psalms 144, it says, God is my loving ally, my fortress, my tower of safety, my rescuer. He's my shield, and I take refuge in Him. Because meditation is something we should be doing every day, it's the one discipline that Satan wants to keep us from doing. It's hard to picture us having time to meditate when we fly out the door in the morning and we come dragging in at night and we just drop over in a recliner somewhere. But that constant running is exactly why we need that calming effect in our life. We have a tendency to see things directly in front of us, but sometimes we just need the rest of the story. And I want to say this about meditation. True meditation is not what we do, it's where we dwell. Do you know that we dwell somewhere both physically and spiritually? We have a verse in Psalms 91, 1 and 2, and it said, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And then it goes on to say, And I will say of the Lord, He's my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom will I trust? Are you having trouble today? And you wonder what's happening in the world, and you wonder if God even knows or cares about what you're going through. My friend, I tell you right now, He is your refuge. And we need to stay hidden in Him. In John 15:7, it said, if you abide in me and I abide, my word abides in you, you can ask what you will and it'll be done for you. When you meditate on the word and God and his word, you have chosen your dwelling place. You chose it. It's a place of answered prayer, and powerfully answered prayer, I might add. God's wanting to take us into all truth. Do you know that you and I can look at the same thing and we both see it totally different because we're looking from different perspectives, different angles? Well, when we know the truth of God and God alone shows it to us, then we know how and why to pray. God's personal guidance is one of the benefits of meditating. In Psalms 119:97-100, it said, oh, how I love your laws. It is my meditation all day long. You, Lord, through your commandments have made me wiser than my enemies, for they're ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for your testimonies are my meditation. I wonder more than the ancients because I keep your precepts. Listen to what God says in the book of Joshua, Joshua 1:8. He says, study this book of instruction continually, meditate on it day and night, so you'll be sure to do everything that's written in it. Only when you prosper and succeed in all you do. Oh, I like that verse. Or there's another one. Blessed is the man, Psalms 1:1-3. Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in that law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth fruit in his season. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. I like those words. How about you? Well, if you get a chance, I want you to take time and just meditate. Meditate tomorrow and see how it feels and see if you feel better doing it. Amen? I want you to think about this in the next few days. And Father, right now we come to you. I thank you for every person under the sound of my voice. Help us, Lord, to very clearly hear you and what you want to do in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless. I'll see you tomorrow.